better an opportunity when we did break out, but I've got nothing but credit to the players in terms of how they went about the game.
Well, the three players that you've got new to the squad, Brody, Alex Matos and Bojan, all had promising moments in the games and all had good games overall, didn't they?
Yeah, and I think you'll see from our point of view what they'll give us for the second half of the season in terms of what the three of them brought us today. Alex in midfield, very competitive, enthusiasm in terms of his play. Bojan in terms of his hold-up play, his link-up play, and giving us a focal point to hit. And certainly Brody, we know Brody coming from down from Scotland, patrol that right-hand side. And I thought they're all difficult game. They're a difficult game for them to come into, but the way the three of them performed today... And credit to the boys. Of course, we did respect our opponents in Manchester City because, you know, currently they're the best team in the world. But we didn't fear them, which was credit to the players. In terms of when we had to engage them, we did engage them. But listen, I take nothing away from them. They're a fantastic team. And from a learning perspective, it will stand us in good stead for the second half.
I think Brody in particular doesn't play like a 19-year-old, does he? You never know. He's so calm and composed.
Yeah, Brody, Alex, you know, we had some young lads out there today that when you play against that level of quality of opposition, you know, they've got internationals right across the pitch. And, you know, obviously... You know, Phil really, I thought he was excellent today for Manchester City. I just thought he was at times unplayable in terms of how he picks the ball up. But I think from a professional point of view, the areas that he operates in and some of the areas he operates in, he's got no right to really, but such is just the level of the player that he is. Obviously, he was devastating for us and got the two goals and two real quality finishes.
We should get Tommy Pender on as well. You talked about him the other day. That's not a token thing for, is it?
But no.
Great moment.
No. No, yeah. And he's definitely got that. And I've been speaking about him. And, you know, he's at a level and a point to his game where I think now if we see fit and it's the right type of game for him to play, I won't hesitate to play him.
You were missing a couple today. How are Cass and
Yeah, no, Cass sustained an injury yesterday in training, so we're going to assess him over the next few days. And Hoggy's just got a chest infection.
Are you hoping to get Hoggy back next week?
Yeah, well, it's all down to the medication and how he's feeling, really. But he's got a chest infection, so he's been prescribed medication by the doctor.
Had two games now where I think, respectfully, probably... Going in, would have thought the chances were slim. You're going to get anything out of them. Now is it sort of redoubling the players' efforts and going into a more winnable run of games and hoping to see a response now?
Yeah, we're respectful for every game that we play. We are respectful, and we know in football you got no given right to say you're going to win matches. You got to earn them, and certainly when we look at the next bout of games coming up, we got to be ready. And set for those games in terms of going forward. So we've got some work to do before our next home game, and that's exactly what we'll be doing.
Yeah, cool. Steve.
Hi, Darren. What will that performance have done for Alex in particular as the least experienced of those new players?
I think it'd be good for him. I think what he did, he was so looking forward to the game. It was almost like I was kind of holding him back, really, because he just really wanted to play. He was so energised for it. And I think with his performance, you saw that, you know, in terms of how he was getting about the pitch and not holding back in any of his challenges. He made the challenge and got booked for it. So I thought, you've got to be careful now in terms of it. But it didn't dampen his spirits at all, really. Credit to him, really, for one so young to step into that arena. But you've got to remember the environment where he's come out of. He's probably used to that quality in terms of in training. So I had no hesitation in playing him today.
And I think it was only a minute or two in when he sort of went down the left and it got forward a bit. How important was it? It's obviously going to be a difficult offensive day for your team, but he did try and throw punches through the
Yeah, and we had to do that, but we knew we had to throw our punches. It was always going to come from deeper, running off the back of them. And we did adventure up the pitch, but I just probably thought the release passes to get them up the pitch could have been probably better, because we thought we had the legs in the wide areas to maybe trouble them. But they're such a difficult team, because when the ball turns over, they just smother and press you and really regain the ball back. And that's credit to them in terms of even though they do play a high line, they're very switched on when the ball turns over in transitions. They're really, really quick and show their athleticism. So credit to the boys in terms of trying to do that. And from a learning perspective, you as much as quality you're playing against Man City, you've got to show that quality against them in order to break their defensive lines.
And not just from a learning perspective, but a confidence one as well. Do you think your team can take something from the team, even though it was hard?
I really do. I sit here, Shea, and the boys, you know, and I've just said to them, listen, it's you felt it, but I think what they were just talking about was just the quality what they were coming up against, you know, and how switched on they had to be from a mental, not just a physical point of view, but from a mental. And I think when you step in the arena, you can talk about it, but when the boys feel it, and in reality, and the arena, that's a learning, and sometimes in moments of defeats like this and like these days like this, it's the learning perspective really from it, and that's where we've taken from today.
Okay, thanks everyone.
Cheers, guys. Thank you. Cheers, Dart. Thanks.